Welcome to Innovations in the Field, brought to you by BASF. I'm Colleen Callahan. A multi-generation farming operation calls Carlisle, Indiana, their home. Dell and Tammy Unger have two adult offspring that farm with them. Lance is full-time, and daughter Ashley works in peak season, handling the application of fertilizer and running the spray rig. They all are partners in Unger Farms Grain. Lance and Ashley also have smaller operations of their own. Dell explains why they set things up in this manner.
In this day and age, you know, to be able to start up on your own without help from, you know, an existing operation is just pretty impractical and pretty impossible. And for the kids, you know, and if you're under 50, you're a kid, but, you know, the kids to have skin in the game but be able to have their own operation where they made decisions, and because those decisions you make on your own operation, you know, come nearer and dearer to you when, you know, you have success and failures.
At this date, the Ungers have just sampled their 2018 harvest, and it looks to be slightly smaller than last year. But then 2017 was their best ever. The story is in what happened during the growing season and what they learned that can be applied next year.
We were running ammonia in March normally. Never really had that window in March. Too cool, too wet. The first week of April, we normally were rolling pretty hard planting. Never really got that window.
But when the cold, wet April weather changed to hot, dry May conditions, Dell said it was all in and nonstop until planting was over. Son Lance said they were running three planters at one time, two for corn and one for soybeans.
We started planting corn and beans essentially a day apart. Just off of past history and what we've been able to do here for us, it's imperative for us to be able to plant our soybeans early.
Then the reality of dry weather set in. It had compounding effects.
Most of our pre-merge or residual chemistry, corn and beans both, was applied at planting or right after planting. Went that six-week time frame and never got enough rain to activate the chemistry. Never got it activated until after Memorial Day and had another flush of weeds. So when we came back and sprayed, you know, post-spray then, had to change our program as, you know, in that regard a little bit. Just a simple fact that, you know, our residual that we had spent the money on and applied didn't get activated.
The Ungers irrigate part of their land, and that made a big difference over the next 6 weeks.
Took care of our moisture and that type of thing. The only really trouble we had with corn was we had some ammonia burn, and it just didn't have enough moisture on especially some of our lighter soils to keep the ammonia in place.
The fertilizer burn of the young corn and soybeans is still top of mind, so next year they may make some changes. Their BASF innovation specialist, Melanie Burke, was an active part of the team as they moved through the season. She worked with Dell and Lance in putting out fertilizer and fungicide trials that have become an important part of their farming strategy. We'll examine what they learned in the strange season of 2018 in our next podcast. The Ungers, plus other leading-edge farmers, are featured in select issues of Progressive Farmer Magazine's Innovations in the Field, sponsored by BASF. You can also go online to dtnpf.com/innovations. Thanks for listening.